This video, I'm going to be creating an animated water in a very easy way. So it's not a simulated water, but it will work for still images or something like that. So I'm just going to create a plane and assign a new material. And I'm just going to go with Arnold Standard Surface Shader. And if you go to the very bottom, you're going to see Geometry. You can go to Bump Mapping and assign a new texture, and noise works the best in this case. And if you go to the bump depth, I mean bump value, you're gonna see noise texture attributes, and you can just change the noise type to pearly noise. And you're not gonna see anything happening, so you should enable texture view in your viewport. And now we see something. So now it's all about changing these values, actually, so I can increase the frequency and maybe more depth. Maybe three or four works the best. If you go too high with it, it will look like a hard surface, hard and rough surface. Yeah. So now I can go back to the bump map node and maybe make it very shallow, like you until you barely see it, because it tends to be more intense in the actual render view. So now I'm just gonna create a skydome light, and maybe I'm just gonna add an environmental map to the actual color. So if you enable this lighting in the viewport, you're gonna see the reflections now. So if you just make it a bit darker, you're gonna see some proper watercolor there. And I'm just gonna go back to the noise. And what you can do to animate it is just type in time equals frame, your frame number. Now it's animated, but it seems to be too fast. So what you can do is go to the expressionator like that and just divide it by something like 50 or something, I don't know. Yeah, it seems to be working. So you can just increase the bump depth to, you know, get the right reflection for this. Or, yeah, bump depth max is the option you want to deal with. And frequency ratio, just ratio, there are a lot of things you can actually do. So, that's it. Thanks for watching, and please subscribe.